this is Solar PVTV from Dubai, once again, from the annual meeting of Clean Energy Business Council. And now we have a pleasure to speak with the chairman of the organization, with Dr. Nasser Saidi, who is the chairman of organization, but actually before he had very big experience also working with the government. And Dr. Saidi, first I would like to ask you, not about the event, but about your actually career and relation to the energy topics.
Well, I got interested in clean energy because I live in a region which is exposed to many environmental problems. We don't have enough water. We have plenty of sunshine. We have fossil fuel, and we've been highly dependent on that. And as a result, we live in an environment which is increasingly polluted. We're adding to climate change. And I could see renewable energy developing. And as an economist, it was very clear that we needed to reorient our economies towards renewable energy.
At the beginning, it was difficult, yes, because renewables were too expensive.
It is, and continues to be difficult because not because renewables were particularly expensive, but rather because, particularly in the GCC and other oil producers, they subsidize fossil fuels. So they make it cheaper to use fossil fuels than to use renewable energy. So two things have happened over the past 2 years which have been important. The first one is gradual removal of fossil fuel subsidies. So all the GCC countries are now gradually removing subsidies. The removal of subsidies means that you're removing a tax off renewable energy. The second thing, of course, which is important, is the large decline that we've seen in the cost of renewable energy, whether it's wind or solar or other types. So the combination of removal of subsidies, fossil fuel subsidies, plus the large reduction in costs of renewable technologies because of technological advance has meant that renewables now are at the forefront in terms of energy policy in the region.
And from the perspective of the minister in the Lebanon government, how do you see now the, let's say, attitude of politicians towards renewables?
I think there's been a big change. And you've seen it in the COP21 agreement, the Paris Agreement. People are now realizing that pollution, climate change is not something that's going to happen in the future. It is happening now. And they can see it happening in their own country. And because of television and media, they can see also climate change occurring in other countries. So politicians are now aware of this. The other thing that I would add is that there is the influence of young people. What you call the millennials and other young people are much more aware of the impact on the environment. And they, of course, are looking forward to their children, their grandchildren. And they realize that unless we do something about addressing climate change today, the future looks very bleak. So I think the politicians are now aware of this. And young people, I think, are much more engaged. So when I look at the Clean Energy Business Council, for example, I see a lot of support from young people.
Oh, there is a lot of also young entrepreneurs, yes?
Yes, and young entrepreneurs. And this is very promising for them in the future because it's developing new activities, it's developing a new investment sector. It means that they can both invest, develop new technologies, and feel good about it because they're helping the environment. It's going to be less polluted. They are combating climate change. So I think you have a combination of factors which is encouraging more and more young people and entrepreneurs to go into this business.
But I think that even more interesting is to speak about business actually, yes? Because now it's not only just combating the climate change, but it's bringing the wealth, yeah, actually, to these countries.
Well, you're right to say that, because I think one of the important things, particularly for politicians, is to explain to them that there is no trade-off between economic growth and climate change combating activities. So what you're opening is a new field for investment, which also will create jobs. It'll bring in new technologies. The best example is what Bill Gates and others have recently announced. They're creating a $1 billion clean energy fund for investment in startups, in research and development, to promote renewable energy. They're not doing it as a charity. They're doing it because they're hoping also to...
Because of the business case.
Because of the business case. And that, I think, sends another message to the politicians, namely that you don't need to be afraid of real energy, of clean energy investments. On the contrary, we are entering a new world which will open new opportunities and job creation. And, of course, this is something that you can compete with internationally. So my message, for example, for this part of the world is that you have been long dependent on fossil fuels. That is history. The future is going to be renewable energies.
And the future started today.
And the future started already yesterday. You are lucky because you have a great deal of solar irradiation. Solar power can be a major source of energy for all the countries of the region, and also, of course, can be a major export product. If you're looking at North Africa or looking at this part of the world and the GCC countries, they should be exporting electricity to Europe, they should be exporting to the Indian subcontinent. So the potential really is for a big transformation of the economies of the region away from fossil fuel towards renewable, giving them a new export base.
And last question, because we are attending the event of Clean Energy Business Council, I would like to ask you maybe not about the past, yes, but about the future. So what are the major milestones and, let's say, points in your agenda for the year 2017?
Well, we as a Clean Energy Business Council want to be able to promote clean energy across the MENA region. So we aim to work both with the business sector as well as with government. We have many events like this and workshops. We'll be focusing on energy efficiency, on solar and wind. We'll be focusing on women in clean energy. We'll be focusing on schools and households and off-grid solutions. Energy efficiency is very important because this part of the world is highly energy inefficient. It uses too much energy to produce GDP.
Because someone said that the best source of renewable energy is efficiency.
Of course, of course. And you can have some 40 to 50% savings of energy use, which of course means that you will be less pollution. So a lot to look forward to.
And we never spoken on Solar PV TV for the international viewers about the Lebanon. Do you have any information how renewable energies will be developing in Lebanon?
Well, Lebanon has the potential more of wind and less of solar. It's a small territory, but we have mountains. And wind can be potentially a major source of energy. We're still at the beginning. But there is lots of interest in developing wind for Lebanon.
Is there any governmental policy or support, or do you have any scheme?
Not yet. I'm hoping to work with government to introduce a Ministry of Climate Change. We have a Ministry of Environment. I would like to see that Ministry of Environment become a Ministry of Climate Change.
So maybe we can also help you to bring some testimonies from other countries.
I hope so. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much. That was Solar PV TV from the annual meeting of Clean Energy Business Council. And we had the pleasure to speak to Nasser Saidi, who was working before in the government of Lebanon and who promised us that he will be very busy with the activities of introduction of clean energies here in the region. Thanks for watching.